let me know if you're in the market for anything.
Yeah. Aphrodite's palace, the most majestic sight on the Golden Isle's skyline.
I don't know if it's the most majestic. There's one mountain in particular I think is pretty regal.
Thank you.
but a mama's boy. Always doing whatever Aphrodite told him to. Like shooting Helen with his arrow to fulfill her bargain with Paris of Troy.
I wonder if Phoenix will test the power of an arrow on the Helen statue. Poor Helen. Once Eros struck her with his arrow, she was powerless to do anything but leave her husband, Menelaus of Sparta, for Paris.
Might have offered Paris power, Hera, but it wasn't enough to win the Apple of Discord.
Of course not. It was a total turnoff. Paris didn't want power. He was a slave to love.
Athena. If Paris had known the Trojan War was coming, maybe he would have taken the battle wisdom you promised him in exchange for the Apple.
Ha-ha! Time paradox!
Wow. You're smarter than I gave you credit for.
Oh, sorry. I nodded off for a second. What was that?
Never mind.
The Apple of Discord. All Hades broke loose over that thing. Three goddesses, toe-to-toe, for the title of most beautiful.
Ah, but our hero knew the apple symbolized more to Aphrodite than a self-regard worthy of Narcissus. That's why she had to win.
Oh yeah? What did Phoenix think it symbolized?
Freedom.
Aphrodite, I have something for you.
I've had enough of your gifts. What I mean to say is, I'm only here to give, not to receive.
But it's another apple for your collection.
It's so beautiful. I want it.
Did you know the Trojan War could have been avoided if Eris had been invited to Peleus and Thetis' wedding?
What? I thought it had something to do with Troy and Greece. The shade Eris was throwing, how did I not put two and two together?
The best parties are the ones that the goddess of discord shows up to uninvited. Everyone knows that.
Cat fight!
To think Hera pulled Athena's hair over an apple. Her own daughter.
Ah, right. The beauty contest. What moron appointed that blowhard Paris the judge?
I'm looking at him.
To be fair, I'd had a lot to drink.
It wasn't Paris's fault. Hera offered to make him king of Asia and give him great riches. Athena offered great glory and renown in war. But show me a god or mortal who could resist Aphrodite's bribe of true love.
Yeah, sure. It was Helen of Sparta's love Paris was after.
So he did exactly what you asked and chose the most beautiful woman. Then, you know, started the Trojan War.
I wanted to win that apple so badly. I started a war for it! To show Zeus! Everything that came after was my fault.
You were acting according to your nature, Aphrodite.
Which is exactly why I'm better off without my essence. My nature caused only pain.
That's where you're wrong, Aphrodite. You can't have one side of the coin without the other. Your passion, your unpredictability, and I'll say it, your jealousy, your vanity, yes, they caused pain. But you know what else they did?
What?
They created some of the greatest adventures, the greatest epics, the greatest stories the world will ever see. I'm a storyteller, I know. Sure, we would all be safer if we just stayed at home, but everything's more beautiful in color. The passion is worth the pain.
Oh, in that vault are my unfiltered jealousies and darkest natures. If I let you in, everyone will judge me. I've been judged before. Aphrodite, rein it in. Aphrodite, you're too much work. Aphrodite, you're too much trouble! Aphrodite, you're too much!
Whoever said that owes you an apology. What a jerk!
I never meant it like that.
Didn't you?
You don't have to compete for my or anyone's love. You are enough. Anyway, if you're that beautiful and have a perfect personality too, well, honestly, it's just annoying at that point.
All right. I'll move my room. Please, take this blessing before you go in there. You can find me at the Hall of the Gods. Get off me, all of you! It's enough already! Why don't you just go get a job?
I had no idea Hermes and Aphrodite were so close.
They even had a child together.
No way. Boy or girl?
No.
Ah, I see. The child was non-binary.
Look at you.
Prometheus, I have an amphora collection. I'm with it.
Thank you. Hera's just jealous that Heracles wore it better than her. There, I said it.
Realized the seeds had to be burned to clear the air.
Let's get rid of these seeds.
Thank you.
Eros needs to calm down and bow. There's only room on Olympus for one. Seriously, Persephone, moving back in with your mother half the year isn't the changing of the season. She's using you. Grow up!
Yeah.
Has me locked down, but I'm out here to play. Telling her to fix that crow's nest, then passes for air. Girl, that helmet ain't doing you any favors.
Ha!
if I could ever love a man like Hephaestus. I mean, that face alone could sink 1,000 ships. Oh, and down below. Oh, let's just say there's no wind time.
I mean to put so much pressure on Aphrodite.
Sometimes we think we're showing love for someone, when really, we're fulfilling our own needs through them.
So you're saying I actually need someone to protect me?
Not exactly, but...
It's so true. I've always had to stay strong for everyone. No one ever takes care of me. Prometheus, it's so hard.
I'd hug you, but I'm chained to a rock. He was already your son.
Well, that was the only moment he lived up to it.
Yeah.
locked away!
A faint hint of perfume wafted past.
That smell.
Thank you.
Unfazed by the jealous thoughts echoing inside the vault, Phoenix was determined to reunite Aphrodite with her essence.
You're definitely bringing some life back to this dusty old hall, Aphrodite.
How soon?
A few months, maybe.
Ah, exciting.
Let me know if you're in the market for anything.